How to find the total area of the circles in a second? What's the first ordinary method that comes to mind? It is to find the area of each circle and then add them all up. To do this, we need to know the radius of each circle. Let's call the radius of the smallest circle x. The radius of the next circle is 2x. The radius of the largest circle is 4x. This length is 8x plus 4x, which equals 10. Solving this equation, we get x equals 5 over 6. By substituting this value into the formula for the area of a circle, we can calculate the areas of the three circles. To find the total area, we multiply by the number of circles. 12 times, 2 times, add up all these values. This is the total area of the circles. Do you like this method? It is not only complicated but also tricky. Because the radii are fractions, you can't solve the problem in 1 second using this method. Throw this method into the trash. Now, let me show you an excellent solution so that you solve this problem in just 1 second. Look at these two diagrams. Different sized circles are inscribed in different sized squares. Naturally, the areas of the two circles are different. But what about the proportion of each circle's area to its respective square's area? Let's calculate it. Wow, the ratio is the same, approximately 78.5%. Amazingly, this ratio is constant regardless of size. Even when multiple circles are connected, this ratio remains constant as long as there is no overlapping or empty space. It's time to return to the original problem. Look at the arrangement of these circles. They are connected without overlapping or empty spaces. Therefore, the area ratio of these circles is the same as the ratio for this single circle. This means the total area of these circles is equal to the area of this single circle. The radius of this circle is half of this length, which is 5. So, the area of this circle is 25 pi. This value is also the total area of these circles. Brilliant idea!